we give drugs to open up those oxygen tubes. Next, we remove the blockage, and after, we give the heart rest and prevent any future clots. Now, you've heard the term MONA, but for the NCLEX, the correct sequence is oxygen for perfusion, aspirin, our antiplatelet congregator, to prevent platelets from sticking together and forming a bigger clot. Nitro opens those coronary oxygen tubes to provide more oxygen to the heart muscle. And morphine helps the heart to relax, decreasing the workload. Now, all these drugs help get and conserve oxygen immediately. So big test tips for nitro, no Viagra, AFib-ending drugs like sildenafil. Remember, AFib will kill since both are potent vasodilators. It causes vascular collapse from low blood pressure. Now, some other highly tested points here. Guys, 3 doses, a maximum of 5 minutes apart. No swallowing, always sublingual, under the tongue. And headache and orthostatic hypotension are common, so guys, we take this drug while sitting to prevent fall risk. Now, a little side note, for chronic angina patients at home, we teach them to call 911 if there's pain 5 minutes after the first dose. Big NCLEX key term here, guys. Pain 5 minutes after the first dose. Now, test tips for morphine, guys. Any chest pain after morphine indicates an MI, even if it's only 1 or 2 out of 10. NCLEX keyword here is chest pain or unrelieved pain after morphine. Typically, more pain equals more tissue death. Now, we fix the clot with cath lab and clot busters. So for cath lab, just think it clears the clot. Also called PCI, percutaneous coronary intervention. Key terms that show up on exams are arterio or even angioplasty. Now, angiographies or even angiograms are images taken via x-rays to visualize the blockage. And plasty means balloon or stent placement, requiring more recovery time. Patients are usually awake, not under general anesthesia. So before, we're NPO 6 to 12 hours, meaning no eating or drinking. And after, patients will lie flat for several hours and are encouraged to drink to dilute that contrast dye, which we'll be covering next. Now, bypass, also called open heart surgery, requires more recovery time, around 3 to 5 days in the hospital. So words including bypass, like coronary artery bypass graft, or even MIDGAD, minimally invasive direct coronary artery bypass grafting, usually a shorter recovery time because there's a smaller incision in between the ribs. Now, post-operative general rules here. We avoid lifting heavy objects, and we protect incisions from infection. So big no-nos here, guys. No baths or soaking the wound. But a shower is okay if they avoid soaking the wound underwater. We want to prevent infection here, so we monitor for redness, warmth, swelling, and draining, specifically at the incision site. If there's any of these, they would report it to the HCP immediately. Now, test tips for cath lab. Guys, always think contrast kills the kidneys, usually used in procedures previously mentioned. So contrast dye, also called iodine, is a thick dye highlighter used to find blockages and narrowing. But it's really hard for the kidneys to wash out of the blood. It's kind of like dumping cement into the washing machines of the body. So think thick dye, the kidneys will die. Now, here are the top 7 test questions that come up with cath lab. Just remember the ABCs. A for allergy to iodine. And yes, warm flushing is normal. So guys, allergies to shellfish is actually not used as a tool anymore to screen for iodine allergies, according to the last NCLEX update. B is for bleeding at the catheter site. Direct or manual pressure on or above the site for any potential bleed. And patients will be lying flat hours after, aka supine. So NCLEX key terms here, guys, write these down. We're not putting the patient in semi-fallers and no crossing the legs. Also, no blood thinners within a 6-hour window. This means no heparin, no warfarin, aspirin, or even clopidogrel. Now, C is for creatinine, always indicating kidney function. Normally 0.9 to 1.2. So remember, contrast kills the kidneys, kind of like dumping that thick cement into a washing machine. So creatinine over 1.3 usually means an injured kidney, also called contrast nephropathy. So we avoid renal failure patients, and key word here, guys, write this down, diabetics on metformin. We stop metformin 48 hours before and after the cath lab. We want to prevent lactic acidosis and nephropathy. And we can give Mucomys to protect the kidneys, but it's not common on the NCLEX. So remember, iodine is like thick dye. The kidneys will die. Always a big NCLEX tip. Now the last C, you can't palpate the fetal pulse after surgery. Guys, we always call the doctor, AKA HCP, healthcare provider. Remember this, pulses equals perfusion. Normally we get diminished pulses, but only 4 to 12 hours max, not 1 to 2 days. So NCLEX keywords here, guys. Cold, cool, or remarkably cool legs, absent pulses or non-palpable, or even just present with a Doppler ultrasound. Big no-no, lack of perfusion. Now we can also give clot busters like TPA to dissolve the clot. So let's review the top tested content right here from our DVT video. Now fibrinolytics, aka clot busters, which are not routine for DVTs but are still used, these guys are like the atomic bomb. They're one-time push drugs. So we give either TPA or streptokinase. But guys, streptokinase has the most allergies associated with it. And the big thing with these atomic bombs is the huge bleeding risk. Since it has an 8-hour or less duration, this means we're most at risk to bleed during that 8-hour window. So guys, no injections at all. No new IVs, no sub-Qs even for diabetics, no IMs, and definitely no ABGs. These drugs can only be given through a compressible site, like an IV. So we never give these through a central line because we can't hold pressure on that central line. Only peripheral lines here. Okay, now after the MI, we want to prevent clots and give the heart some rest. So heparin is used to stabilize unresolved clots and prevent the growth of current ones. Now big NCLEX keywords here, guys. Heparin does not dissolve clots. Only clot busters dissolve clots, like TPA. And to give the heart some rest, we use BCD drugs, beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, and dilators like nitro. So here are the big NCLEX test tips for pharmacology. Again, guys, we took over 10,000 NCLEX questions here, and here are the most tested key words. Write these down. Again, heparin prevents clots by thinning the blood, so we have a huge bleed risk. So the therapeutic range for coagulation therapy is to keep the PTT between the ranges, guys, write these down, 46 to 70, always on the NCLEX. Typically, a standard is 3 times max range. Now, the antidote for heparin is protamine sulfate. So our memory trick is hepit, like a frog. Just think H for heparin is hepit for PTT and protamine sulfate. Now, for all the NCLEX keywords and memory tricks for beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, and dilators like nitro, we include all that stuff in our pharmacology section. So we'll leave a link right here for the membership site.